Yo, come here. Come here.
The top charting rapper 6ix9ine, who is known for his controversial stunts and snitching on the entertainment industry, is facing a critical condition that is threatening his life. The rapper, whose real name is Daniel Hernandez, is known for dropping bombshells, and he has made many enemies in the past and has been convicted for his criminal association. After spending nearly 2 years in prison, the rapper is back, but it seems so that his life is in some serious danger. In today's video, I will break down the main reasons why 6ix9ine's critical condition is scary. Without further ado, let's get right into the video. The 24-year-old hardcore rapper 6ix9ine is known for his unique persona, aggressive style, and is usually involved in a number of controversies. After spending several years on the indie SoundCloud rapper circuit, Hernandez achieved mainstream celebrity with Fifi, a hit single he made Nicki Minaj. But this star is dying just as quickly as it was born. The rapper has become famous, but that comes with a number of scandals. In 2015, 6ix9ine got a lot of negative attention due to his controversy involving a young child and was also arrested following his connections to organized crime. He pleaded guilty to charges involving racketeering, illegal firearms possession, and aiding in attempted assassination as a part of the violent Trey 9 gang. But how did a young guy go from being an upcoming rapper and influencer to criminal? First, you need to understand how Daniel Hernandez became 6ix9ine. It is no doubt that the rapper had a tough childhood. 6ix9ine's life fell sideways in his teenage years. When he was 13, his father was murdered a block from his family home, according to the New York Times. The experience had a huge impact on Hernandez, and he soon dropped out of school and started working odd jobs to help his mother. As Hernandez rose through the ranks of internet fame and notoriety, he attended a party on February 22, 2015. Where he performed inappropriate acts with minor girl, and he was 19 at that time. After this 2015 criminal case, Hernandez seemed to focus on growing his Instagram followers by promoting his brash persona and making music on SoundCloud. But his connections were never right, even his manager Jordan, who has a criminal record. At that time, he was a fugitive from New Jersey authorities, who have charged him with narcotics trafficking. In 2018, Hernandez seemed to get in trouble with the law again several times. In May, he was reportedly arrested on charges of driving without a proper license and assaulting a police officer. Soon afterwards, he reportedly hurt a 16-year-old in Texas and was arrested in New York. But all of that was overshadowed on July 22nd when he released Fifi, his biggest song yet, a collaboration with Nicki Minaj and Murda Beats. That same night, after a day of shooting the song's music video, Hernandez was reportedly kidnapped. Later on, a member of the 9 Trey Gangsters, also known as Treyway, a part of the Blood Street Gang, was charged with a crime in November. Federal authorities believe Hernandez is also a member of the gang. After a number of procedural delays and appeals, Hernandez was sentenced in October to 4 years of probation and 1,000 hours of community service for 2015 minor case. On November 19, federal authorities announced a series of indictments against Hernandez, Jordan, and others they said are members of the 9 Trey Gangsters. They accused the crew of running a drug dealing ring and enforcing their activities through violence. The charges include racketeering and illegal firearms possession. Federal authorities also said the group conspired to commit murder. If proven true, Hernandez and everyone else charged could face life in prison. So on January 23rd, Hernandez entered a guilty plea to the charges related to his involvement with the Trey 9, and he also agreed to cooperate with the federal prosecutors in their investigation. He flipped on members of the 9 Trey Gangsta Bloods, a gang founded by prisoners on Rikers Island, the notorious New York City jail. At his 2019 trial, the rapper initially denied the charges against him but entered a plea bargain, giving evidence against other gang members in order to get a reduced sentence after potentially facing a maximum of life in prison. He testified against former members of the 9 Trey Gangsta Bloods. After that, he served nearly 2 years in the prison, and after his release from jail due to COVID-19, the rapper put on weight and is in serious health condition due to the same. As a result, the rapper was admitted to hospital a few days back and is recovering. Well, there's more to this story. Tekashi 6ix9ine is suffering from severe health conditions. However, the suffering is due to overdosing of diet pills. When the rapper was out during COVID-19 on a bail basis, he went into a drug addiction. Moreover, being indoors didn't help him recover from any of his health conditions and have made the situation worse. As a result, he started consuming diet pills, as it was an easy job for him, and it resulted in a tremendous weight gain. As a prescription by the doctor, the rapper was prescribed to take one dose of hydroxycut pill, but he took 2 tablets of hydroxycut each day. Besides, he consumed caffeine on that, which made him suffer from nausea and unconsciousness. However, he was taken straight to the hospital after that. Later, he was shifted to the emergency ward to avoid unwanted emergencies. It's not new because 6ix9ine is a drug addict and consumes it regularly. However, the rapper has decided to put control over his habits. The doctor strictly prohibited the consumption of drugs as Tekashi 6ix9ine was already on a diet pill. Furthermore, the star says that he is getting over his addictions and will surely quit it soon. He is recovering day by day and will be quickly discharged from the hospital. We just hope that he recovers soon. So there you have it. What do you think about 6ix9ine's critical condition? Tell us in the comment section below. Thanks for watching.